Why is my OneDrive full? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com with what turns out to be a surprisingly common question. I haven't put anything in it yet, and I'm told my OneDrive is full. I need to buy more storage. What the heck? Honestly, it's a feature. I know, it's a silly, stupid thing that it happens so frequently. But yeah, it's a feature, and in some light, it's actually a good feature, but it's not something that's for everybody. And unfortunately, it ends up getting turned on for too many. With that very vague description, let's just go right into it. It's the OneDrive folder backup feature. Now, if we go quickly to my Windows 11 machine here, I've got OneDrive installed. I'm going to go ahead and click on Settings, click on the Backup tab, and then click on Manage Backup. And you'll see here, Manage Folder Backup. I want to be clear, I do not have this feature turned on. And yet, kind of looks like I do. Each of those items is checked. And of course, Start Backup is seemingly the only option to make this go away. I suspect that that's what's causing people to occasionally turn it on without realizing that they've turned it on. Let's have a quick look before I turn it on, because the way OneDrive manages this feature can be really, really confusing. So I'm going up Windows File Explorer, and if I take a look at Documents, you'll see that I've got a document in documents.txt. In other words, I just have a file that's in my documents folder. And if I take a look at the full path to that, well, it doesn't show this way, but if instead I go to my local disk, users, my login name, and I go to the documents folder there, that's the documents folder. That's what this documents shortcut is really all about. It's about this specific folder on the hard drive. So we can see it's on C, users, askleo, documents. That has this folder. What you may or may not realize is that OneDrive may have its own documents folder, which has nothing in it. That's quite confusing, but it's there. You may not have this. You may not have this folder yet. So with that being the normal condition, your documents are in your user folder, and OneDrive, in fact, if we take a quick look here, you'll see that we've got desktop, documents, pictures, and OneDrive all as subfolders of this folder that is your user directory. Let's turn on the feature. I'm going to go ahead and say Start Backup. Now, Windows does something. OneDrive does something, and it starts synchronizing the files that it found. I've turned it on for all three of these folders. I'm going to go ahead and close the settings for now. And you'll notice that things kind of sort of changed here a little bit. There was a bit of a repaint when we weren't looking. If we take a look right now, documents, it looks a little different, but it's empty. What happened to my documents? They got moved. They are now in the OneDrive documents folder. If you look at this PC, it's still a shortcut, but in fact, it's a shortcut to the OneDrive documents folder. So all of the shortcuts that have been created here, your quick access, I believe now goes to this documents folder again in this PC, which is in your OneDrive folder. Look at that carefully. You'll see that it's not askleo documents, it's askleo OneDrive documents. Now, the reason this happened, the reason that OneDrive does this, is that by moving your documents folder, your pictures folder, and your desktop folders into the OneDrive folder, rather than alongside your OneDrive folder, is that putting it in your OneDrive folder causes it to become part of OneDrive, causes it to be automatically backed up to the cloud. It's confusing, because we now have two different document folders. We have this OneDrive documents, and yet still on this PC, in your users folder, you have this documents folder, the old documents folder, that is now empty. In some cases, the old folder will have this, where are my files? In this case, because I've done this previously, my desktop folder, which has disappeared here, has a where are my files, a shortcut on it. That may help explain where your files went, but the bottom line is that your original documents folder, where you may have had everything, is now empty because everything's been moved over to the documents folder that was created within OneDrive. Okay, so things got moved around. That's okay-ish. It's not what I would have preferred. It's not the solution that some other cloud storage services use, but it is what it is. Everything within your OneDrive folder is now being backed up to the cloud, and your documents, desktop, and pictures folders have been placed there instead of where they were originally. What if you had over 5 gigabytes of data in your documents already? Remember, the free account, the free OneDrive storage account, has a 5 gigabyte limit. What that means is, as you then synchronize what you just turned on, your system is going to try and put more than 5 gigabytes into the cloud. It's going to fail. You're going to end up with the error that says, yeah, your OneDrive isn't big enough to hold everything you're trying to put into it. All you did was turn on backup, and it's because you're trying to back up more than 5 gigabytes worth of data. So what do you do? What do you do if this happens to you? Well, there are two solutions. One is to move things out of your documents folder. In other words, the documents folder that now lives within OneDrive has a bunch of stuff in it. It's got 5 gigabytes or over 5 gigabytes worth of data. Make folders elsewhere. Move some of the data out from within the OneDrive folder. That'll free up space within your OneDrive. It does mean that you now need to keep track of these files are in my documents folder that are in OneDrive, and these other files I had to move out, so they're in a different folder somewhere else. It also means those other files that aren't in OneDrive, you need to take responsibility for backing up some other way. I'll touch on that in a minute. It gets confusing. Again, it gets confusing in a different way. Now you have some files that are in documents, some files that aren't, some files that are getting backed up, some files that aren't. It's not the solution that I generally recommend. My recommendation is to not enable this feature to begin with. My recommendation is to not use the storage, the file and folder backup that OneDrive offers. So if I go back to managing folder backup, you can see that it now says stop backup on each one of these. If you happened to have it turned on, click each one of those. Stop the backup. Yes, I mean it. Stop the backup. Yes, I mean it. Stop the backup. Yes, I mean it. Now, when you do this, OneDrive will not undo what it did. It did not move the files back from the documents folder in OneDrive to your old documents folder. You still need to do that. In other words, you're still going to be out of space until you move your files and folders back to their original location in the documents folder, in the pictures folder, in the desktop folder, whichever folder has your data. That's unfortunate, but it also kind of sort of makes sense from their side because they could actually end up doing damage if they randomly started undoing this work. So turn that feature off if it's been turned on. If it's not been turned on and you encounter this dialogue, which I believe you will also encounter if you're setting up OneDrive for the first time, there are two ways to deal with this. One is you can simply click the X and skip this entirely. This will not turn the feature on. This simply bypasses managing file and folder backup completely. The other thing you can do is uncheck these individual folders. This little checkbox is actually something you can click on. So this way, for example, I'm only backing up pictures if I elect to turn this on. Since I don't want it on any of these folders, I'm going to uncheck that as well. And now you can see I can't start the backup because I'm telling it not, there's nothing to back up. In which case, the only thing to do is to click the X in the upper right-hand corner and make this dialog go away. And once you've done that, then yeah, you're back to where you were before OneDrive started backing up. If you had it enabled, I have to remind you, if you had it enabled for a while, you'll still need to go back in and move the files and folders from the OneDrive documents folder to your regular documents folder, from the OneDrive pictures folder to your regular pictures folder, and potentially from the OneDrive desktop folder to your regular desktop folder. But once you've done that, this is something that you shouldn't have to worry about again. So we just turned off backup, but isn't backing up a good thing? Absolutely. This backup is more confusion than it's worth, in my opinion, for all of the reasons that's probably left your head shaking as it is, right? What I've gone through is very confusing. I understand that. And that's one of the reasons I don't like this feature. Instead, you should be backing up your entire machine anyway. You should be backing up every day. You should be using an image backup program, be it a monthly full backup and a daily incremental or something, right? You should be doing something that's causing your machine to be backed up on a regular schedule anyway. And that should include not only what's in your OneDrive folder, but what's on your entire machine, which would include all of your documents, regardless of where they're stored. That's the solution. That's the solution that won't confuse you with all these random folders getting created in your OneDrive folder. That's the solution that will save you from almost anything, for losing files, whether they're in OneDrive or not. That's my recommendation. Don't use OneDrive folder backup, but instead use a backup of your own devising. And that typically is an image backup using a tool like Macrium Reflect or Easus To Do or any of a number of other good solutions. I hope that's helpful. The companion article for this video goes through this again in more detail and might be a little bit easier to understand in conjunction with watching what I'm describing on screen. So go visit askleo.com/138559 for that, for related links, for comments and more. Until next time, I'm Leo Notenboom and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.